Today, I would like to talk about Logitech mices that I happen to own. One of them is a Logitech MX Anywhere 3S. It's a compact mouse, pretty nice features and a lot of advantages, but there are some downsides to it as well. So I eventually had to switch to another mouse a few months ago, which is a Logitech Lift. It's a ergonomic, quite compact mouse, rather for a small hand like mine, and it also has a ton of features, and its main feature, as you can guess, is being ergonomic mouse with a nice grip. So let's dive in into this and find out why I had to switch and what are the upsides and downsides of both of these animals. I would like to talk about Logitech MX Anywhere 3S. First of all, it's a compact mouse. It's very small, it's very lightweight, which makes it very portable, and my son is playing some computer games on my Mac and he's using this particular mouse, and of course not the Logitech Lift because it's too unusual, and this one fits his hands perfectly. I thought initially when I was buying it that it will fit my hand perfectly as well, but eventually it turned out to be not the case. Also, the other important feature of this mouse is multi-device, so it can switch between different devices using this button. So you can connect it via Bluetooth up to three devices, and let's say you can switch between your Apple computer and between your Windows computer, or between your smart TV, or maybe use it with your tablet. So that's very useful. I use it with my TV sometimes, I use it on a couch, and there is no problem with it, and it's very easy to switch back. You don't have to go to Bluetooth settings every time. So yeah, this is another killer feature from Logitech, and it's also applicable to other Logitech mices like the Logitech Lift, which I have. Now, the next feature is extra buttons. So it has two buttons on the side and one on the top. Logitech software allows to tweak those buttons. By default, those are mapped forward and backward in a web browser, and this one, I don't know. Logitech allows to map those for particular software, and you can tweak your mouse for specific apps on your Mac or on your Windows PC, which is very nice. So this is an advantage of the Logitech software in general, and beside that, it allows you to tweak other things, like the speed the cursor is moving on your screen, and also the speed of your scrolling wheel. And speaking of scrolling wheel, it's another advantage because in this particular mouse, Logitech uses specific technology called MagSpeed, and it allows it to switch between different modes depending on how fast you're spinning the wheel. So if you're spinning it slowly, it will give you some haptic feedback, and it's very precise scrolling. It's useful sometimes in a web browser, sometimes in some specific software. But if you're starting to spinning it fast, it goes very smooth, like a buttery smooth scrolling, and allows you to scroll long pages or long documents pretty much efficiently. And yeah, this is a very cool feature. Charging. So it charges via USB-C cable, and the port is located over here, not over here, like on the Magic Mouse belly. And it allows you to charge your mouse and use it at the same time, which is a big advantage because this particular mouse, if you use it every day from 9 to 5, it will last like for a few weeks, 3-4 weeks, I would say, from my experience. And yeah, the buttons are quite good. They are not noisy and they are nice to use. Overall, the build quality of this mouse is premium. The plastic on the sides is a soft touch, the plastic on top is hard, and also the scrolling wheel is made from metal. It's a very nice choice. As for me, and I also miss it on my Logitech Lift mouse. This is my take on the Logitech Anywhere 3S mouse and its advantages. But yeah, speaking of disadvantages, and the main reason why I had to switch to Logitech Lift is its size. And at first I thought it would fit perfectly, but then I realized that I really have to squeeze it between my thumb and my pinky finger, which means that I gave strain to my hand all the time, and eventually I developed some pain in my fingers and in my arm, and it just didn't feel well at all. I mean, I couldn't work productively, I had to do something with it, so I ordered a new mouse, and on top of that I took some vitamins and I did some exercises, and believe it or not, in 1 month of not using this mouse on a daily basis and doing those stuff, the pain was gone, just because of this particular mouse, which we will talk about next. Now, I would like to talk about Logitech Lift, my mouse of a choice. So first of all, the first advantage of this mouse, the obvious one, is that it's an ergonomic mouse, which means that it's easier to hold it with your hand. You can grab it naturally like a handshake, use it all day, and you will not have any pain or any unpleasant feelings in your arm or in your fingers like I had with Anywhere 3S. Beside being ergonomic, it's a very nice and high quality build. So it's solid. I mean, when you squeeze it, it doesn't make any sounds or anything. The plastic on the back is a soft touch, and as you can see, it's it has some texture to it, which is gives you a very nice grip. And the front side is made of a regular plastic, but it's also nice to touch. The buttons are not clicky at all. They are very silent. And the same I can tell about the scrolling wheel. And the buttons over here are a bit more clickier. And they are supposed to help you to scroll pages horizontally and use specific features for which you can map your shortcuts to those buttons in the Logitech software. On the bottom, you can see the button for switching between different devices, just like on Logitech 3S. And here it's a power switch. And below, you can see that there is this lid, which I can open. And there is a AA battery inside. So this battery allows this mouse to run up to 2 years. And so far I've been using it for 4 months and I haven't checked what the battery level is, but I believe it's higher than 50% by now. I think, this is quite a good choice made by Logitech. And also here, as you can see, there is a USB dongle that you can take from here, and you can use it with devices that don't support Bluetooth connection, such as your old PC, or maybe you just have too much Bluetooth connections between your computer and your other peripheral devices, like speakers, headphones, mouses, and other stuff, and you just want to minimize it because some users, they have issues with, for example, their Bluetooth headphones while using too much Bluetooth devices at the same time with one computer. I don't have that issue, but yeah, if that's an issue, there is a way to resolve it with this mouse. And this sensor again allows it to work on any surface, so you can use it on your lap, on your couch, on a desk, on a glass surface, anywhere where you happen to be working or just using this mouse, it's good. For the wheel, for the scrolling, it's quite good. It's not as good for me as on Anywhere 3S, first of all, because it's not made from metal, but from soft touch plastic. I like metal more. And also this one, when you spin it fast, it's just a nice feeling. I mean, it has some weight to it, and this one doesn't. So the scrolling is a bit more chunky, especially when you're trying to scroll slowly. I don't find it very smooth, so I often use this mouse with my right hand, and with my left hand, I'm using my Magic Trackpad, and I use it for scrolling, for zooming, and for panning between different desktops on my Mac. So this combo, I find my best combo so far for input on a computer or other devices for the past 20 years. And generally this mouse is suitable for small to medium hands. If you have a bigger hand, then you can get a larger model available from Logitech and other brands. And also, if you are left-handed, there is a version for left-handed people as well. But yeah, the downsides, what can I tell you? It's the only one, it's size. Basically, it's not as small as Logitech 3S. So if I travel, I would rather take this one with me, and I can put it anywhere. But this one requires just a bit more space. And also sometimes when it's sitting on my desk and when I'm moving my arms to grab something, I can just hit it accidentally because it's pretty high, as you can see. But yeah, aside from that, there are no downsides. The ergonomic part is very nice. I can really use it all day, and I really enjoy using it, especially in combination with my Magic Trackpad. So yeah, let me know what you think, and if you have additional questions regarding both of the mouses, let me know in the comments below, and let's continue the conversation, and thank you for watching.